A local prosthetic center unveils a state-of-the-art technology on a local amputee and a Iraq War veteran.
It's a new bionic ankle that will dramatically increase the mobility among amputees. Eric King shows us how it works.
I think it's been about a month, and I've been counting down the days.
He's a soldier and a single dad, so mobility is mandatory.
I'm getting fitted for a new prosthetic called the iWalk, the Bion. It's the top of the line, the newest prosthesis out.
Luckily, technology is on his side.
Most amputees are going to be amputees for a long time. I'm an amputee myself, have been for 20 years.
And we couldn't tell.
Couldn't tell, but you know, eventually, if I didn't have a device that was mimicking natural motion, natural energy return, I could expect over time to start seeing some degenerative arthritis in my knee, back, and hip. And these are things that we commonly see with amputees because they're compensating in subtle ways with their gait in order to use a device that's not acting as an anatomical joint would.
This is the bionic ankle, or BIOM as it's called. It's got a fully functioning computer inside that somewhat acts like a controller to a Nintendo Wii. It's the closest thing to a human ankle on the market, and it's being unveiled right here in Louisville. TJ lost part of his leg while overseas in Iraq. He developed a cancer forcing its amputation. Today, you wouldn't know it. Again, a testimony to technology.
The new one, that's what it replaces. It essentially replaces your calf and your Achilles.
Eric King, WLKY News.
The funding for many of the new developments in the prosthetics comes from the Department of Defense and the VA. It's the result of an increased need following recent wars and military actions.